always look on the bright side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you forgot, and that's to learn, smile, dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps. Just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing.
Hello one and all, my name is Rio and welcome back to another match day vlog. So tonight is the big one. Chester FC host Stockport County at home at the Swansway Chester Stadium in the Vanarama National League North. So it's a huge game for both sides, both for different reasons, because of course Chester FC do have playoff aspirations and really do need the 3 points tonight to keep those hopes alive. And also Stockport County have title aspirations too, so if they win tonight they will go top, they will go ahead of Chorley. So it's a massive game for both sides, and also in this league as well, our nearest rivals Telford, they're at home against Altrincham, so hopefully Telford will get beat tonight. So if that is the case, and if we beat Stockport, then we'll be just outside the playoffs and goal difference too. So it could be a pivotal night in the promotion race as well, so it should be a great game as well. So of course, I hope you enjoyed this video today. Please leave a like and subscribe to my channel, and also feel free to comment down your thoughts on the game below. Let's get into today's video right now. Stockport County will be making a short journey from Greater Manchester, and so far this season they have done really well. So since their relegation to the National League North back in 2013, from the Vanarama National League, they have struggled to find consistency at this level, and their supporters have had to remain patient because, to be fair, they are one of the bigger fishes in this pond of clubs. So they are one of the biggest clubs at this level as well, so their supporters have had to remain patient. But this season, they have done really well, so they actually got to another inconsistent start. They actually started off the season quite poorly as well. However, since the turn of the year, they have come on a long way, and they have come on leaps and bounds too under Jim Gannon, who has been their manager for a number of years, so he knows the club and this league from inside out too, so he knows what to do at the football club as well. Since January, Stockport, they've only lost one match in the league, so that was away at Brackley Town a couple of weeks ago, and it's quite understandable really, because Brackley there, they're also doing really well there in third place too. So they've only lost one league match in 2019, so they have done really well to catch up with Chorley, who are only top by a couple of points as well. So as I say, Stockport do win tonight, hopefully they don't, but if they do win, then they will go top ahead of Chorley as well. So it's going to be a pivotal night for both clubs, both Chester and of course Stockport too. So it's going to be a very tough game for us tonight as well, because Stockport, they are a really good side, they have some really good players too. And also they have a couple of former Chester FC players, which are Paul Turnbull, Nyal Bell and also Jason Gilchrist. So let's start off with Paul Turnbull. He was here last season for the first period of it, at least. He was one of John McCarthy's so-called Coupe signings, and how all of them turned out really. We signed the likes of Ross Tanner, Andy Halls, Kingsley James as well, John McCoon, Paul Turnbull. At the time, we were all, getting excited about those signings, but in the end, they all failed to, produce what we all expected, really, what we anticipated. So, especially Paul Turnbull as well, he disappointed us too. So, he left us, I think, was in January last year as well, due to that financial crisis we had. So, we had a very stop-start season last season. It was an absolute horror show, both on and off the field, and, he has signed for Stockport as well. So, I think he is their captain too, so he is one of their key players as well. Then after that you have Nyal Bell, who has actually had two spells here. So he had the spell here back in 2016 from League One side Rochdale. It was a loan spell as well. Didn't really provide anything there, because he only made three appearances for us, and he actually didn't score a single goal then. However, he had another loan spell last season, this time from North East based side Gateshead, who played just one league above us, and he did a bit better for us last season. Scored a few goals for us, he found the net a couple of times, and especially in the pre-season friendly against Walsall, he scored a fantastic goal there, fabulous goal there as well. So made a bit of a decent start. However, he did actually fall down the pecking order a little bit, so he returned to the North East in January of last year too. And the final former Chester SC player who will be playing for Stockport County tonight is Jason Gilchrist, who again had a loan spell here. This time it was back in 2015 from Premier League side Burnley. He actually scored a couple of times for us, so he did quite well for us. However, unfortunately, he did pick up a bit of a bad injury for us, so he has to return to Lancashire. So it was a bit of a blow for us at the time. So we have three former Blues returns. To the Swans way tonight, so it will be interesting to see what sort of reception they do get as well. So our previous meeting this season was back in December, where we drew 1-1 away at Stockport County at Edgeley Park, and I thought on that day we were by far the better team. Thought it was a great game as well, good crowd there, good atmosphere too. We talk about 700, sadly there were about 100 Chester fans who had to be sent back home because of a so-called dispersal order, but it was a bit of a not good for them, but it was still a fantastic game as well. So hopefully more of the same tonight. Hopefully we will go one better as well. So to Stockport's promotion ambitions, and also to boost our own promotion ambitions as well. So it is a vital game for us tonight as well. Hopefully we will extend our unbeaten run to 5 games as well, because we are coming on now just at the right time as well. Because I remember a couple of weeks ago we lost 4-0 away at Altrincham, and I thought at the time that it was all over, but since then we have come a long way. We have drew against Leamington, and also Chorley as well, and also we have run away at Darlington and Nuneaton as well. So we have picked up some vital points lately as well, so hopefully pick up a few more points tonight, and hopefully we will be in a great position ahead of another home game on Saturday against York City as well. So can't wait for it now. What better match it should be tonight, a night under the lights as well. Hopefully see a big crowd there too, hopefully around 3,000 as well. Should be a great atmosphere as well. So of course on to my score prediction, which is Chester FC 2, Stockport County 1. So for Chester, I think Anthony Dudley and Ben McKenna will score for the Blues, and for Stockport I think Jason Gilchrist will score for them. So I think it'll be a tight game, but still I think it will produce hopefully a couple of goals to talk about too. So it shall be a fantastic game, fabulous occasion too. So of course I hope you enjoyed the video today. My match day vlog will be coming up right now, so stay tuned for that as well. And also don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to my channel as well, and also feel free to comment down your thoughts on the game below. So let's take it to the Swansea Chester Stadium. Come on City, we can do this. Let's get a big win. Come on lads, don't disappoint. Side of life. Always look on the right side of life. For life is quite absurd, and death's the final word. You must always face the curtain with a bow. Forget about your scene. Give the audience a grin. Enjoy it. I just arrived at the Swans Way for tonight's crucial game between Chester FC and Stockport. It really is a massive game now, and the nerves are, I must admit, they are starting to kick in just a little bit, but it should be a cracking night under the lights, it should be. Hopefully a big Blues win tonight, so I can't wait for it now. Come on City, we can do this.
nothing will come from nothing, you know what I say? Here is your Chester FC squad for tonight's game. We are in a 4-4-2 formation, so in goal is number 1 Grant Shenton. In defence is 2 Bradley Jackson, 3 Matty Waters, 5 Danny Livesey and 6 Simon Grant. In midfield is 4 Sean McAllister, 7 Ben McKenna, 8 Captain Gary Roberts and 11 Craig Mahon. And up front is 9 Akwasi Asante and 10 Anthony Dudley. On the substitutes bench is 12 George Waring, 14 Steve Howson, 15 George Green, 16 Scott Burton, 17 Dan Mooney. And here is your Stockport County team. Enjoy the vlog. Come on, you Blues.
Already 1-0 to Stockport, absolutely frustrating with that one. Poor defending again for this goal. Just a free header in the back post and it's now 1-0 Stockport. Gutted. Stockport just had another chance then to make it 2-0. Come on, City! Come on, City! Their play had a half volley on the edge of the area. Easy save for Shenton, but they're just giving them too much space here tonight. Not a great start at all, still 1-0. Roberts, oh, lucky. Come on! Come on, City! We have a corner! A shot by Gary Roberts was deflected. We have a corner, come on! Chester 0, Stockport 2. I am absolutely infuriated. We're giving them far too much space on the right hand side here. It's far too easy. Easy goal for them. Game over. 2-0. 20 minutes gone. Don't know what to say. It's just shambolic. Played about half an hour here, still 2-0 to the visitors, and not happy with both goals. Really soft goals to concede, but fair play. I think Stockport, they've been by far the better team, playing some really good football. However, we, just like we were on Saturday, just hoofing it up and hope. So we haven't got a clue. We're not closing them down at all. We're just not in it tonight. So yeah, still 2-0 Stockport. Got a lot of work to do to even get back on level terms. So. Yeah, half an hour play, still 2-0. Watford just said, Chester 0, Stockport 3. Again, absolutely shocking defending that was. We're just giving them easy streets. Never known the worst first half performance in this defensively. And former Chester player Nyal Bell scored. What an up. We're just absolutely hideous tonight. Sorry, but this is awful. It's going to be like 5 or 6 this week. Got no hope tonight. We have actually won the corner. It's gone in by Waters anyway. Matthew Lawson's just hacked away. Dear me, this is absolutely embarrassing though. And now we just played into Grant Shenton. How many times are we just hoofing it back and forth? It's awful. It's
just like Nuneaton on Saturday, not playing it on the ground. Mike Barrow's got an absolutely outstanding pitch there, and we're just abusing it by hoofing it up. Hopeless. Stockport were in yet again then. Grant Shenton made an easy save, but again he had another chance. No one closing Stockport down at all. This is gutless. Yeah, we did. Oh, come on. Oh, okay, so a free kick by Gary Roberts just went in, and Stockport have cleared it out, so we actually have a corner now. We have a glimmer of hope, but I mean a glimmer of hope at all. I honestly can't see us coming back now, but we have a corner anyway. It's going to be taken by Sean McAllister. Don't know. God. Come on now. Stockport just got it away, but we're on the ball again. The cross is coming. Oh. 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 Lucky. We just had a header. Great save by the keeper. But we have another corner. Come on, City. So it's came in by Ben McKenna. And Stockport. Oh, wait. No, we have it back. Oh, Stockport just cleared it away. Oh no! Oh, that was so close there. We just had a header. Decent block by the keeper there, but we came close to getting a consolation. So the half time score is Chester 0, Stockport 3. In my opinion, that was an absolute embarrassment, I thought it was. Awful defending for all three goals, just giving them easy streets, in my opinion. Nyal Bell has been really good for them today, and also Finn Stockport has done really well, but big work to do in the second half. Come on. Oh, lucky. Asante's just had a shot which was blocked. Second half, nothing's really happened, to be honest. Played about 5 minutes, but we are in possession now. Oh, lucky. Cross went in, but still don't. I wouldn't really say we're playing okay. Still not good enough. But, still 3-0 Stockport. I'll give him his due, but Grant Shenton's just made a really good save. Stockport were in on the right hand side, and their player lashed the ball towards goal. It was a really powerful shot, but Shenton managed to palm it out and put the now off a corner. Come on, oh no! Okay. Decent by Matty Waters. Come on, City! Coming into it a little bit more now. George Ware and Pedro went miles wide. I mean, we're playing a bit better, but you know, we need to get the 4 goals only to win the game, and I don't think it's going to happen. So yeah, we're still 3-0 to Stockport.
The 50-50 draw at half-time. The ticket numbers are 3-5-3-0-5, winning £440, and the second prize.
Stockport just had a chance there. One of their strikers just dragged a powerful shot wide. So yeah, that's all that's happened over the last couple of minutes. Ramoni! Oh! Probably the only decent shot we've had all game, really. Decent work by Craig Mahon, but his shot still went miles over. Oh no! through. Fair play to George Waring. Fair play to George Waring. That was a good strike there. And the Stockport keeper's made a fantastic save at his near post. But actually looks like Waring is in, has been injured in the process there. But probably the, you know, that was a decent shot on target actually. But still, you know, still not getting into Stockport. They've been much better than us tonight. Nyal Bell has just missed a sit for Stockport from just a couple of yards out there. A bit of a let off, which you know, could have made it 4-0 there. So a bit of a let off there. Chester 0, Stockport County 4. Well, fair play to Stockport. I thought that was a fantastic goal. Really good move there. Fair play, but it's all about us, not Stockport. Not acceptable at all, that. Unacceptable, that. No one put a foot in it at all. No one went for the ball at all. It was too easy. And now it's 4-0. Utterly embarrassing. I don't know what more to say, really. Absolutely shocking. Gary, oh, speculative Gary Roberts effort from 20 yards went just over the bar, but the main feeling now, the consensus is just deflation. 15 minutes left now. Yeah, Stockport being by far the better team. They've been really good tonight. We've been shambolic, really. So, yeah, humiliating. Stockport just have a penalty, which can make it 5, as if it wasn't bad already.
No, I'm
God so almighty. Yeah, I can see why they gave it as well. It was a blatant challenge and just sums up the evening, really. So it's going to come in any second now. Chester 0, Stockport 5, and as you can tell, every single person's leaving now. Coolly taking penalty, and it's 5-0. I am absolutely embarrassed. Absolutely embarrassed. Never seen anything worse like it, really. At home this season, by the way. Never seen anything worse at home this season. Shocking. So, yeah, 5-0 now. The next time I talk, it'll probably be 6, no one knows, but yeah, what a horrific night. Awful. I just told you it's now 6-0. Man, I don't know what to say. Another easy goal. I don't know, I honestly can't. Speechless, basically. Shambolic. You know, I was really looking forward to this, but Stockport, they've been 1,000 times better than us. I think they deserve to win the league on the basis of this, and, you know, I don't know what to say, really. It's just an absolute horror show, basically. Absolutely abysmal. Full-time Chester 0, Stockport 6.
haven't got anything to say or for more reactions soon.
Chester FC, 0 Stockport County, 6. I am absolutely not heartbroken, but I'm just embarrassed with that tonight. I honestly don't know how that could possibly happen. I don't know. Because after that Blythe debacle back in August where we lost 8-1, we were promised by the management team and the players that would never happen again. But guess what? Promises haven't been kept, have they? And we had to witness another absolute horror show tonight. An absolute circus that was. No defending that tonight at all. It was gutless, spineless, shambolic, shocking, disgraceful, inept, naive. You can say every single word you can about that. It was absolutely awful, though. Well, Stockport, you know, fair play to them. They were absolutely outstanding, I thought, Stockport. And if they don't win the league, then I'll never know, because they were outstanding tonight. They played some fantastic football on the, on the service. Well, they played some really good stuff. Could have been about 8-9-0, to be honest. You know, they were a fantastic side, and I think they'll go on to win the league. But for us, you know, playoffs are definitely out the window now, because Telford, they picked up a point against Ulster, but that's not the point really. It's all about us, and we had to win tonight, or maybe even get a point, but we just failed, and failed quite convincingly too. You know, we actually played better against Liverpool in that pre-season friendly. It was that bad tonight. We even played better against Liverpool, bloody Liverpool. It was absolutely shambolic, and I supported Chester for most of my life now. You know, I stay to the end because that's why I support Chester. I'm really loyal. But even, you know, I was having a bit of a debate with myself, you know, whether to stay at the end or not. It was that bad tonight, and no defending that at all. It was shambolic, though. Oh God. So the first half, it was really bad. I thought Stockport, they played some good stuff, and we just reverted to hoofball, just like Saturday at Nuneaton. We were just hoofing the ball all over the place. Even though we beat Nuneaton on Saturday, I even said in my post-match thoughts that we weren't outstanding at all on Saturday, and tonight we just played the same, we just occupied the same tactics really, just hoof it everywhere and hope. Simon Grant, no disrespect to him, he was one of the main culprits, but the whole team as well, just hoofing it up to Asante and Dudley, who just didn't do it, didn't hit a barn door really. So, you know, Stockport, they made it 1-0 for Manchester play, Nyal Bell. It was a shambolic goal to concede, though. A bit of a mishap, you know, defensively as well. One of their plays, he headed it across the face of goal to Nyal Bell, who just simply tapped it home with his head to make it 1-0. So really poor defending there. It wasn't even schoolboy defending, really. It was nursery defending. It was that bad. And all night, you know, Stockport, we just gave them easy street, really. We gave them all the time in the world, and they just... you know, in the end, played themselves to a convincing win. Then the second goal was just as bad, really. You know, really poor defending yet again, giving them far too much space down on the right hand side. And Stockport made it 2-0. We actually had a couple of chances there where I think, can't remember who it was now because I'm that deflated at all. Can't really remember any of our chances, but I do remember us having the chance. Someone blazed it over the bar. I can remember, and also I think Danny Livesey, he had a header which was saved by the Stockport keeper. It was a decent save, to be fair, but other than that, we just didn't hit a barn door in the first half. And Nyal Bell made it 3-0 to Stockport. He scored his brace of the game and his second goal of the game as well. Just an easy goal to score too. So first half, absolutely shocking, you know, inept, naive, you can see the whole dictionary really. It was that poor. Second half, if you thought the first half was bad, the second half was even worse. It was absolutely shambolic, it was shocking, it was. You know, we gave them far too much time as well, and they eventually made it 6-0. It was just an easy win for them in the end. So, Stockport, they made it 4-0. Was it Sam Walker? You think it was Sam Walker who made it 4-0. The fifth goal, it was a penalty to them. Sean McAllister, I think the blood got to his head a little bit there, you know. Tempers flaring a little bit, and he just brought down the Stockport play for the penalty. The Stockport play just dispatched it really easily into the bottom corner to make it 5-0. 5-0. We had a couple of chances after that as well. Craig Moore and Gary Roberts placed over. George Waring, I thought he was actually okay when he came on, after he came on. He had the chance which would have got a mere consolation. It would have been just a consolation at best, really. Wouldn't have got anything out of the game, but you know, we did have a great chance. I think it was our only shot on target too. And fair play to Stockport's keeper. He made a you know, a good save to keeping us in the near post. And after that, Stockport, they made it 6-0. Sam Walker getting his second goal of the game, I think it was. And Grant Shenton, he should have easily saved that, though. It was a 25-yard goal, you know, Grant Shenton should have easily saved that, but, you know, far too easy in the end. So it was a, oh, God, it's going to take me a while to get over that tonight. It was absolutely, it's absolutely horrific, it was. It was shocking. So, yeah. You know, questions need to be asked. Not about our management team, I don't think there's a blame, but some of the players, you know, some of the drills which are on the field now, I think some questions need to be asked about them as well. I don't know what to say. Stockport, they were outstanding, so fair play to them. I think they'll go on to win the league, but for us, you know, all the hype going into this game, we actually had a decent chance, but now, I don't know, I'm really hurt, you know. But yeah. You know, can't say anything good about that at all. It was absolutely horrific. I've been supporting Chester for nearly all my life now, you know, for most of my life's eternity. And I've been to I've been going to literally every single game home and away for a few years now. And I haven't really witnessed a display as bad as this. I have witnessed a few under the John McCarthy and Marcus Bignett era, but not much more worse than this tonight. So, got a lot of work to do anyway. So our next game is at home against York City on Saturday. Be interesting to see how many actually turn up to that game. I'll be going there, of course, because I'm still going to go to every single game. But I don't, you know, if a lot of people just don't bother going, I don't really blame them, really. So we have York at home on Saturday in the Roman Derby. So yeah, we'll be going to the game. So of course, we'll load a match day preview. And the vlog out soon as well. Stay tuned for that as well. And also, I hope you enjoyed the video. No, actually, I don't hope you enjoyed the video today, because we lost 6-0. So if you do dislike this video, then don't blame me at all. It was a shambolic result for us. So, but also, if you want to, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel as well. So until the next time, see you then. But boy, that was bad. That was bad. Good night.